YouTube doesn't give out any awards until you pass 100,000 subscribers. So I made my own to celebrate my first 100 subs. I'm a seller nerd. My name is Fredrik. Now let me show you how and why I made this thing. Once you get to 100,000 subscribers, you can apply for a YouTube Creator Award in silver. Good looking, but also made of unobtainium and never gonna happenium. When I started publishing on YouTube, Instagram and Twitter in December 2021, I decided to celebrate all the small things. So when I suddenly passed 100 YouTube subscribers, thank you to each and every one of you, I just had to make my own award. The reason the moment came as a surprise was I haven't posted much lately, but Tom's Hardware, Hackaday, Gizmodo and a Portuguese site picked up my James Webb Space Telescope model video, and it gave me a lot of views and quite a few new subscribers. Welcome! Keeping it in line with the official awards, this one for 100 subs is made out of plastic. And I spent an entire day making it. Am I happy with the result? Oh yeah. Is it the most vain thing I've ever made? Absolutely. All I want to do is keep making and keep learning. So I'll just ignore the vanity of this project. But I do love it though. And I got to use a lot of different techniques making it. 3D printing, vinyl cutting, laser, and even a bit of woodworking. So, to celebrate being over 100 on both YouTube, Instagram and Twitter, I made a plastic YouTube Creator Award for myself.
I started Infusion 360 using an SVG logo I found online. Extrude, fill it and make sure the playpiece is 0.3 mm smaller than the opening to fit in there once it's all done. Printed with 0.4 mm layer height and a 0.6 mm nozzle on my FlashForge Adventure 3, it took 2.5 hours. Then the boring part of any project, sanding, filling and sanding. I used wet sanding this time and went from 120 grit all the way up to 1200. And I tried a new filler, but after a while I went back to one I trust, as the new one wasn't really filling the gaps. Once I was happy with how the plastic pieces looked, I got to painting. Basic spray paint in red and white from a local supplier. And it looks good. In between, while paint was drying, I started working on the back. I cut out a piece of 4mm plywood, sanded some, filled in the most damaged edges with wood filler, sanded, and painted it white. After the first layer of white paint, I realized it wasn't the color I was looking for, so I went for black spray paint in the end. I used the heat gun to quicken the drying of the spray paint on the wood. While that works well, don't do it like I did. Don't get overconfident and use too much heat too slowly. The paint will boil. Luckily, this exact part will be covered later by the play button. Then there are the letters and the YouTube logo. With the background being black, I wanted it in white. So I made the design in Adobe Illustrator and imported the SVG into Easel to make my G-code. I used my CNC with my DIY vinyl cutter thing and cut it out. But I soon ran into an issue. The letters aren't very big and my vinyl cutter isn't 100% precise, so weeding the cutout was harder than I liked. Luckily, I remembered a technique I've seen Deadpool use, there's the link in the description, combining painter's tape and laser. So I imported the SVG into Lightburn instead and changed from vinyl cutter to diode laser on my CNC. It was way easier to weed out. Once it was weeded, I applied a layer of black paint to prevent bleed out, and then painted it white, letting it dry for a few minutes and the stencil is removed. Looks really decent for a vanity project, doesn't it? Then I attached the play button using double-sided tape. I would have used super glue, but I'm not 100% sure it'll stay like this forever. See, this little line where my black paint kinda messed it all up? I'm wondering if it will bother me enough to try and do something about it at a later point. We'll see, so for now, it's just taped on there.
That's it. I've uploaded the play button model to printables.com and there's a link in the description. Now I need to find somewhere to put this on my wall. While I do that, YouTube thinks you would like this video. That video. I don't know. I can never remember where that is. Anyway, if you made it this far into the video, I really appreciate it. Thanks for watching and I'll see you next time.